Hello friends, today we are going to discuss one more new topic, that is piece representation, which we started in the previous lecture. Now what exactly the piece representation is? In the last lecture we discussed it. It is comprised of four components, that are performance, environment, actuators and sensors. In order to design any agent, one has to specify the piece model to that particular agent. Piece is a type of model on which AI agent works. When we define an AI agent or rational agent, then we can group its properties under piece representation model. For example, in the last lecture we discussed that for autonomous car agent or taxi driving, suppose this is our agent and we want to design it, then first of all we have to specify its piece model. Until and unless we specify the piece model, we cannot be able to design our agent, that is autonomous car. For example, in case of autonomous car, in this particular picture you can find autonomous car means driverless car, or many times taxi driving example is also given. Taxi driving means whenever we describe taxi driving or autonomous car or driverless car or smart car, all are the one and the same thing. Okay, in case of this autonomous car, performance can be safety. We always require the passenger requires safety. Passenger also require that we should reach the destination in time. Passenger also expect that the taxi or this car should not move in an illegal lane, on an illegal lane. Okay, and obviously the passenger always want the car should reach to the destination. Passenger also want that there must be comfort during the driving, during the travel. Okay, so this could be the performance measure for this autonomous car agent. For this car, environment could be roads, could be other vehicles that are running on the road, road signs, there could be pedestrians. So this whole comprises the environment for this autonomous car agent. What could be the actuators for this autonomous car? Obviously steering, accelerator, brake, horn, because whenever car is moving on the running on the road, with the help of steering only it can take the left or right or move ahead like this. So steering is acting as an actuator for this particular agent. Similarly, accelerator to increase the speed, to reduce the speed. So accelerator and brakes are required to take the actions. Okay, that is why accelerator and brake are the actuators, as well as horn is also actuator in order to give the indication to the other vehicles. Horn is required, that means with the help of horn the car is taking some action. That's why horn is one actuator for this car. Okay, then what could be the sensors for this particular autonomous car? Obviously cameras are there in order to check the whether the some other vehicles are there in ahead of him, ahead of this car or not. So cameras are required, front cameras are required, back cameras are required, side cameras are required. GPS is also required to show the car the route, the alternative routes towards the destination. Speedometer is also required for the car in order to get the input regarding speed. So all these are the sensors. Okay, so these sensors are things can be the sensors for this car agent. Okay, so this is all about piece representation. Now whatever piece parameters you find on the screen are not same for the other agents. These could be the piece parameters for car. Okay. For example, vacuum cleaner, the piece parameters could be different. For other intelligent agent or rational agent, the piece parameter will be different. But you have to remember that whenever we want to design some agent or intelligent agent or rational agent, we have to completely specify the piece parameter. This is the importance or significance of piece representation. Environment wherein the agent work come in variety of flavors. The flavor of the task environment directly affects the appropriate design of agent program. Obviously, type of environment will decide what program we should write for our agent. Okay, so task environment can be of different types. We are going to cover in this lecture what are the various types of environments. Sometimes the environment is fully observable, sometimes environment is partially observable, and so on. So we will cover this in the next coming slides, means slides to come. Next point in designing an agent, first step must always be to specify the task environment as fully as possible. Okay, task environment. So we will cover in the next slides to come. To specify task environment means specifying the piece information, which we covered in the previous slide. Piece environment is required, and types of environments we are going to cover in the next slide to come. All these are interrelated points: agent, agent environment, rational agent, then piece representation, types of agent. All these are interrelated and comes under the AI theory. Next point is the performance measure is the criteria that determines how successful an agent is in the given environment. Obviously, when we design some agent, we always need to assess whether our agent, designed agent, is successful or not. So how you will assess this performance? Obviously, performance measures are required. Next point, there is no fixed piece representation for all agents, which I explained in the few minutes before. For example, piece performance measures for the autonomous car are safety, time, legal drive, destination, comfort. This could not be the performance measure for vacuum cleaner agent. For vacuum cleaner agent, it could be time or electricity consumption or both or something else. For example, vacuum cleaner should suck the dust in less time. Vacuum cleaner should consume less electric power during its work. This could be the performance measure for vacuum cleaner agent. Okay, so from agent to agent, AI agent to agent, the piece parameters changes. As a general rule, it is better to design performance measures according to what one actually wants in the environment rather than according to how one thinks the agent should behave. Means the performance parameters generally depends on the environment in which the agent works. It generally do not depends on how we think agent should behave. What our opinion is, that is not so important. What exactly then important is what type of environment in which the agent is working, that decide the piece parameters. This slide explains you few examples of piece representations for three different types of agents. For example, first agent is medical diagnosis agent. The P parameter could be healthy patient, minimize cost should be minimized, patient should get healthier. This could be our performance measure. Okay, what could be the environment for medical diagnosis agent? Environment could be other patients, hospital environment, other staff. This could be the environment. Means in medical diagnosis agent, in this particular agent where the agent work, this agent work in which environment it works? It works in the environment where the other patients are there, hospital is there, building is there, staff is there, equipments are there. Okay, now for this medical diagnosis agent, what could be the actuators? Actuators could be what actions this agent can take. You have to imagine, suppose there is some robot which is useful for medical diagnosis. What actions it can take? Obviously, actions are taken by actuator part. Okay, so what actions this agent can take? Agent can take various types of tests. Then it can do the treatment of the patients. This could be the actuators. What are the sensors for such agent? Obviously, in order to give the information, perceive the information for this medical robot, obviously keyboard must be there. By entering into the keyboard, this agent can get the some idea about the measurements. Okay, second agent could be, for example, vacuum cleaner agent. So for vacuum cleaner agent, what is the piece representation? What could be the piece representation? Whatever you see on the screen are not the complete list. You can add other performance measure also depending upon your need. You can customize these piece parameters. Okay, these are not fixed. These are just representative. Okay, I just added few points only. Okay, you can add the PEAS parameters even more than this, no problem. Or you can reduce as well. Okay, for vacuum cleaner, what should be the performance measure? For vacuum cleaner agent, cleanliness could be the performance measure, efficiency with which the agent works, battery life if it is battery operated, and generally it is battery operated because it moves from room A to room B, so battery should be consumed less, means power consumption is a performance measure. Security could be the performance measure. So in which environment the vacuum cleaner work? Obviously in the room. This environment also contains table, wood floor, carpet, and various other obstacles in the room, obviously. So in a vacuum cleaner agent, what actions vacuum cleaner can take with the help of what? What are the actuators of vacuum cleaner? Wheels are there, vacuum cleaner, if wheels are there, then and then only the vacuum cleaner can move from room A to B. Vacuum cleaner must have brushes, vacuum cleaner must have vacuum extractor to suck the dust, okay? Vacuum, what are the sensors? What could be the sensors for a vacuum cleaner? Obviously, it requires camera in order to check whether there is dust or not. Dirt detection sensors is also maybe required. Clip sensor is required. Bump sensor is required. Infrared wall sensor is required. Whether there is a wall, there wall in between the two rooms, there is obviously wall. So it should not hit the wall. The cleaner must not hit the wall, because that's why there must be infrared wall sensor. So you can reduce this list of sensors to vacuum cleaner, or even you can add number of sensors to vacuum cleaner depending upon your need. Okay, so you can customize this piece parameters for your agent. Okay, it depends on what exactly you want your agent to do. That makes the piece representation. But you have to remember that in order to design any agent for your environment, for any environment, for any problem, you have to specify completely piece parameters for that agent. Then only you can be able to design that agent. You can write some agent function, you can write that agent program. Okay, this is what I want to tell you. The next is now different types of agent environment. Agent environment means environment in which agent work. It is also called as task environment. So environment is everything in the world which surrounds the agent, but it is not a part of agent itself. Whatever surrounds the agent is nothing but environment of that agent. So environment may contain obstacles, environment may contain walls, it may contain tables, chairs, etc. Whatever may be the environment. Environment is where the agent lives, operate, provide something to sense and act upon it. Okay. Obviously, these sentences I took from the reference book as it is, in order to give the glimpse, in order to give you the idea about the text language of the Simon book or this Russell book. But obviously, once you get the concepts of these particular points, you can write your answers, or you can write these ideas in your language, no problem. Okay, so task environment or agent environment. Task environment are of six types. The first category is your environment can be fully observable or partially available, observable. It can be static, or it can be dynamic. It can be discrete or continuous. It can be deterministic or stochastic, single agent environment or multi agent environment, episodic or sequential. So one by one we will cover all these types of task environments. Fully observable or partially observable. If the agent can sense or access the complete state of an environment, complete state. State means what? The information. Okay, information. If the agent sensor
if it has access to all the environment at a time, then it is called as fully observable environment. Else, otherwise, it is partially observable environment. It is easy as there is no need to maintain the internal state to keep the track history of the world. Okay, in a fully observable environment, the agent can perceive the whole environment. There is nothing left. So the knowledge of the whole environment the agent have. Therefore, there is no need to maintain the internal state of the environment. Means there is no need to store the information of environment into its memory. Obviously, in order to save the history, agent requires some memory. But in case of fully observable environment, there is no need to maintain that history, previous history, okay, of environment, because the environment is fully observable. Everything the agent can see. Nothing is hidden. Okay. An environment might be partially observable because of noisy and inaccurate sensors, or because parts of the state are simply missing from the sensor data. For example, in case of autonomous car agent, the environment around is partially observable. Why? Because agent do not know what could be the obstacles after 5 minutes on the road, or what are the turns, whether to take right or left. The agent do not know whether there is a jams on the, or rallies are going on the roads. So environment is partially observable because the car do not know what will happen next 10 minutes or after 15 minutes. But in case of vacuum cleaner agent, you can find that vacuum cleaner knows everything about the environment. Room A, he knows everything. For room B, also he knows everything. Nothing is hidden. So it is fully observable environment. Second category is deterministic or stochastic. If the agent current state and selected action. First of all, I want to tell you, current state means what? The state in which the agent is, the environment is, and goal state means what? Goal state means the state where the agent want to go, at which particular desirable state the agent want to go or want to achieve. That is called as goal state. Okay. If the agent's current state and selected action, try to recall back percept sequence or percept and action. We have covered this in the previous lectures. Now, first point under this deterministic versus stochastic is, if the agent's current state and selected action can completely determine the next state of the environment, then such an environment is called as deterministic environment. Many times in the environment, the next state or next event depends on previous events. For example, conveyor belt is there, you know all that, there are sections for the conveyor belt, products are moving on the conveyor belt, first it goes to some raw section, then it goes to manufacturing section, then the product on the conveyor belt goes to the quality section and then testing section, likewise the sections are there. So the action of the agent in that case depends on what happened in the previous section. Okay, if in the previous section the product is faulty, then there is no need to take the next action in the next section. For example, in the conveyor belt example, that means the environment is deterministic. Deterministic means if the current state and selected action, if it can completely determine the next state of the environment, what will happen next in the environment, if it depends on the current state, then such an environment is called as deterministic environment. Otherwise, it is stochastic. Stochastic means random. The agent exactly do not know what will happen in the environment. It is random in nature, cannot be determined, it cannot be computed. There is no formula to calculate what will be the next state of the environment. Okay. Agent need to worry about, therefore, in stochastic environment, agent need to worry about uncertainty.
So uncertainty word is very, very important. In case of stochastic environment, there is uncertainty of environment, but in case of deterministic environment, there is no uncertainty because everything is certain. Everything is certain. Everything is deterministic. Episodic and versus sequential environment. In episodic environment, there is a series of one-shot actions, and only the current percept is required for the action. And in case of sequential environment, an agent require memory of past actions to determine the next best action. For example, chase and taxi driving are sequential environment. These environment around chase and autonomous car or taxi driving can be considered as sequential environment because there are sequence of actions. For example, the car is moving and at some junction there are four routes. So which would be the best route in order to go to the destination? It depends on sequence, what happened in the previous section. Okay, so it is a sequential. In the chess game also, the move of the opponent makes you to decide what action to take on the chess. Okay, opponent, whatever actions the opponent has taken, obviously in order to maximize our performance, we take an appropriate action. Okay. So this is a sequential environment. This is called a sequential. Okay. In episodic, there is a series of one-shot action. Whatever means only the current percept is required for the taking the action. There is no need of previous history. There is no need of previous history. Okay. Whatever percept is there at the moment, based on that, you take the action. Okay. That means one episode. Okay. In that episode, what happened? What percepts are there? Based on that, you directly take a action. Don't worry about what happened in the last episode, last time. Okay. So these such kinds of environments are called as episodic environments. Next type of category is single agent versus multi-agent environment. The name itself suggests or indicates that in single agent environment, only one agent is involved. In case of multi-agent environment, multiple agents are involved. For example, in the chess, there is one opponent and you are playing with respect as against your opponent. So it is a two agent environment. Similarly, multi agent environment means if the environment contains two or more than one agents or two agents, then it is a multi agent environment. If only one agent is involved in environment and operating by itself, then such an environment is single agent. For example, vacuum world agent, it is a single agent environment. You can recall back the vacuum cleaner world we have covered in the previous lectures. In that, room A was there and room B was there, and only one agent was present into that. That was one vacuum cleaner. Okay, so it has to deal, that vacuum cleaner has to deal with only two rooms. That means the environment, there is no other opponent. Okay, no other agent was present in the room A or room B. That's why it is a single agent environment. However, if multiple agents are operating in your environment, then such an environment is multi-agent. For example, autonomous car or taxi driving, it is a multi-agent environment because there are multiple agents are there, multiple cars are running on the road. Apart from your car, other cars are also running on the road. So it is a multi-agent environment. Next category is static versus dynamic environment. If the environment can change itself while an agent is deliberating, then such environment is called as dynamic environment, else it is called as static environment. For example, taxi driving or autonomous car is an example of dynamic environment. Depending upon, because the environment is continuously changing, sometimes the two cars are moving in front of us, in front of our car, or sometimes only one car is there, pedestrians are there, other obstacles are there, road signs are there, turns are there. So environment is changing continuously, and according to that, the agent is deliberate to take the action. Means to deliberate means to plan, to plan based on some perception. Okay, so taxi driving is a kind of dynamic environment. Okay, while whereas crossword puzzles, you can treat at it as static environment. So second point, if you closely observe, static environments are easy to deal because the agent does not need to continue looking at the world while deciding an action. There is no need to look at the world. World means environment. There is no need to look at the environment. But in case of taxi driving, taxi, this autonomous car, has to look continuously around the environment. What is happening? What, whether there is something change in the environment, whether some other car is running towards us or not, whether there is some road sign is there or junctions are there, railway bridge is there. So car has to look look to the environment. It has to scan the environment continuously with the help of its sensors. That's why car driving or taxi driving or autonomous car, one and the same thing, are called as are working in a which kind of environment? Dynamic environment. Next category is discrete or versus static, discrete versus continuous environment. Now what exactly discrete environment is? If in an environment there are finite number of percepts and actions that can be performed within it, then such an environment is called as discrete environment, else it is called as continuous environment. So in the previous lecture we have already discussed what exactly percept means, percept sequence means, and actions. And we have, if you can recall back, we have drawn shown on the screen that there was a agent function table. It is a table for internal characterization of external characterization of agent. In that we have shown the agent function table for vacuum cleaner world, vacuum cleaner agent. There was a percept sequence A comma dirty, then move to the left. If A comma clean, if this is the percept, then move to the right, move to the left, suck the dust. Are you getting this point? So this percept and percept sequence and corresponding actions, if they all are finite in number in your environment, then such an environment is called as discrete environment. Otherwise it is continuous environment. For example, vacuum cleaner world, in that agent function table, to the best of my knowledge, only 5 to 6 percept sequences we kept in that particular table, agent function table, and corresponding actions were there in the second column. Okay, so six percepts and six actions. That means 6 is a finite number. So if in your environment, if there are finite number of percepts and corresponding actions to be performed, then such an environment is called as discrete environment. Otherwise it is continuous environment. So chess playing, or you can say your vacuum cleaner world, is a discrete environment, and taxi driving is a continuous environment. So today we will stop here, and in the next lecture we are going to cover various types of agent, such as simple reflex agent, model based reflex agent, goal based agents, utility based agent, and learning agent. Thank you very much.